Just a short time from now, Vice President Mike Pence and Senator Kamala Harris will face off in their one and only high-stakes debate. The candidates will be separated now by more than 12 feet and by that plexiglass that had been requested by the Biden-Harris team. Vice President Pence at first had said no, but then acquiesced overnight. Of course, a lot has unfolded since the presidential debate. The major outbreak at the White House will be front and center tonight. That plexiglass, a powerful reminder of the unfolding crisis. Mary Bruce right there in the debate hall in Salt Lake City tonight.
With just hours to go, Joe Biden today cheering on his running mate with a thumbs up. Kamala Harris and Mike Pence set for their first and only face-off, and already the pandemic is front and center. The candidates will both be seated behind plexiglass more than 12 feet apart. Harris testing negative yesterday, Pence testing negative today. Even as the outbreak at the White House grows by the day, Pence's team insists the vice president is safe to debate. His doctor saying Pence has not been in close contact with anyone who has tested positive and does not need to quarantine. But Pence was seen here at what is now being called a super spreader event, that Rose Garden ceremony, sitting right in front of Senator Mike Lee, who shortly after tested positive. The vice president was last with the president in the Oval Office last Tuesday before Trump tested positive. Pence's communication director, Katie Miller, who was traveling with the vice president, had to abruptly leave Utah yesterday after her husband, White House advisor Stephen Miller, tested positive. She has since tested negative. But the Harris team has been taking no chances, demanding those extra precautions, including that plexiglass. Pence, the head of the coronavirus task force, initially mocked the request. Miller saying if Senator Harris wants to use a fortress around herself, have at it. But overnight, agreeing if such a barrier is critical for the Harris team, then we're not going to let it stand in the way. The hurdles for this event paling in comparison to the challenges of next week's presidential debate. The president, still battling COVID, is promising his supporters he'll be there to debate. But Joe Biden is drawing a line, saying there will be no debate until Trump tests negative.
I think if he still has COVID, we shouldn't have a debate.
Mary Bruce with us live tonight. She's in the debate hall. And Mary, of course, this vice presidential debate a short time from now, really taking on added significance in these times in this country. Both candidates will make the case that they're ready to step in at a moment's notice as commander-in-chief. And of course, Mike Pence will have to answer questions tonight, given what we've seen unfold at the White House over the last week, given the fact that he's the head of the coronavirus task force in this country.
David, he is known as On Message Mike, and Pence is expected tonight to argue that they have done everything they could to tackle this crisis, while Harris, a former prosecutor known for her fierce cross-examinations, is going to make the case that they have failed the American people. And David, history is about to be made here tonight. Kamala Harris is set to become the first black woman, the first Indian American to ever sit on this stage. It is a huge moment for women, especially young girls across this country. David?
It is a big night ahead, Mary. Thank you. We'll see you right here, Mary, just a short time from now. I hope you'll join George, Lindsay, and me and the entire political team, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by the debate at 9, right here on ABC.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.